Hey everyone, today I have the waffle plate attachment for the Cuisinart Griddler series. The specific model numbers that this is compatible with are listed in the title of this video. So without further ado, let's go ahead and unbox this thing. Nothing much to it. You get, of course, the two plates, one for the top and the bottom. You see the attachment location is the same as the stock one. And you can see, of course, the four sizable waffles that you can make out of these plates. It also comes with an instruction manual and also a brief recipe guide on several different variations of waffles. I also wanted to compare it with the ones that came with my Griddler, and you can see that the material finish is also non-stick coating. It has very similar build. I would say that Givaud waffle plate shows a little bit more seams and is definitely a little bit thicker than the stock one that came with my Griddler. But otherwise, the divots and grooves match up perfectly fine. I didn't have any compatibility issues when I inserted it into my Griddler. But before you use it the first time, you want to wipe it down with a damp cloth. It's suggested to do so because these could have been sitting in a warehouse for who knows how long and collected quite a bit of dust. So just for some, you know, sanitation and cleanliness, just wipe it down a little bit before you use it for the first time. Inserting it into my Cuisinart's GR-4N Griddler here is really simple. Just with the stock plates, you just gotta align it properly with the clips and then push down. Same idea with the top plate. So according to the instructions, the recommended heat is for 400 degrees Fahrenheit, and then the setting to be on is the griddle mode. So those were the settings that I used the first time I attempted to make waffles with this. Of course, once the optimal temperature has been reached, I sprayed it down with some cooking spray and then went ahead and poured in my batter. And then the instructions also recommended to start at 3 minutes and then increase the time if you wanted more crispier waffles. Now, of course, your results will vary based on the batter that you use and possibly even the model that you have. But for me, 3 minutes was definitely not enough, even to get decently soft waffles. So what I tried was I continued to leave it on for a couple more minutes, but it didn't really improve the look of the waffle. It was, for the most part, very soft. Again, this could be also the issue with my batter. But when I did it the second time, I actually changed it to the grill and panini mode so that it would heat up both plates more. And doing so, I found that it got a much better look to the waffle. So I might suggest that you try the grill and panini mode versus the griddler mode suggested in the instructions. Then cleaning up is just as easy as setting up. You just need to pop off the plates once they've cooled down, and you can go ahead and hand wash them as needed. So overall, I would say this is a nice addition to my Cuisinart GR-4N Griddler. If you're looking to have kind of an all-in-one system to also add waffles to the mix, I think it's worth picking up. It's not too expensive. And unlike traditional standalone waffle makers, you don't have to remember to flip them because both sides are already getting hot.